Hey, what's going on everyone? Joel Wallace here. So today I'm going to talk about the Blackmagic, the URSA broadcast camera with the Fujinon 8-128mm lens. And this lens is only available with the Blackmagic URSA broadcast camera as a bundle. So let's just jump in and we'll start from there. This is the Fujinon LA16x8-128mm 4K lens. Big features that you're automatically gonna see right off the gate with this is that you're gonna have a zoom rocker. This is gonna allow you to be able to zoom out, zoom in. You're not gonna have to worry about when, say for example, you're shooting on a DSLR lens, that when you go to zoom in, your focus changes. Whereas on this lens with the Fujinon, when you go to zoom in, you set your focus, you zoom out, everything's gonna be in focus from there. So it's parfocal. You can use this in a church setting, for example, and what you're gonna gain out of this is that you're gonna have a really nice, good quality lens that you're gonna be able to do that long distance shot. So say, for example, you had a PTZ camera, and if you don't know what PTZ stands for, that's pan, tilt, zoom. So you have a PTZ camera off to the right, we'll call that camera one. Camera two, we have this bad boy right here, and then camera three, we have off to the left. So this would be our long shot to be able to get the pastor, or you know, if there's a guitarist up on a stage or whatnot, this would be a really good lens to be able to zoom in and follow that subject. And then you'd have your other two cameras on the side be your cutaway cameras, or those can do some zoom ins and do some zooms out, but this would be a really good lens for kind of all around in that scenario for getting your long shots in a church. Another really cool, unique thing that I discovered with this camera when I was playing around with it, how do you set the back focus? What's really cool with this is that this one electronically does it for you in a way. It's super simple. You'll hold a button down for about 5 seconds. The camera lens zooms in, you pull your focus, then you hit the button again, it zooms out, you pull your focus, hit the button again, and you're done. Pretty simple. It's just taking out a lot of the process in the back end of having to set the back focus and then setting the front focus. It's electronically doing the back for you. You still will definitely want to use a focus chart, and if you don't have one, you can easily print one off the internet or just use an object roughly about 10 feet away. I'll post up and have another video that I'm going to post up of how to set the back focus for this camera, and I'll put a link in here somewhere, one of these corners down here for you, or else I'll put it in the description. This lens has a macro built into it, so with a slide of the focus ring, we could slide it forward, and now we're in macro for getting those extreme close-up shots. With the DSLR lens, we're going to have to change out our lens to a macro lens and then switch back as we're going through different shots. Again, coming back all in one camera, it has it built in. Other features you're gonna have is that you're gonna have a manual iris ring, as well as you can have this go to automatic as well. There's a button on the front that you can actually have it set to automatic iris or manual iris, but it's nice to always have that ring to be able to do the fine adjustments yourself. Other features, we kind of covered about having the servo zooms, the rocker to be able to zoom in and zoom out. We can also turn that off, and then we can do those whip lash kind of style zooms. So for stylistic or like in a documentary reality TV show, we can easily zoom out, zoom in to get those cool effects or that shots that we want. It's a little tougher with these cameras to be able to do that. It is sort of possible. I've done it before. It's okay, works somewhat okay, but not as cool as how this turns out. And then another cool feature that this lens has the capability of doing is being able to add in a rear zoom and focus control. And what that means is that in a studio, what you can do is instead of having to physically go up and adjust focus from here, you can have this up on your sticks or your tripod or on your studio boom, and now you can control zoom, you can also control your focus. So pretty cool features with that, and that's more of in a studio application. So this really is a pretty sweet combination that you get with this package for either documentaries, ENG, multicam studios, church live streamings, you name it. If you have any questions or if there's anything that I didn't cover that you'd like to know, feel free to ask away in the comments. I'll also put my email address down below in the description for you. I'll also put the whole build that I've got going on with the camera and everything that you saw in this video. I'll put all the links down below as well. And be sure to like, subscribe, and follow. Thank you.